All right, welcome back to Kings of the Old World qualifier number one. We're here in the first qualifier for the biggest tournament of 2022. And we've got Minimalt up against Musketeer. So Minimalt this time picking Dutch. Musketeer this time picking British. We saw a Italian's pick from Minimalt and a Malta pick from Musketeer. So our British player gonna go for an early mana here. That's the beauty of slamming it down straight away is you're gonna get access to that settler that it's gonna spawn. House started now by the Dutch player, a little bit slower, but doesn't matter so much. Gathering coin so he can trade villagers. So Dutch have one of the more unique ecos out of the original Euro Simp lineups. Their coin being much more central to their economy. New settlers to gather it to start straight off the bat. Musketeer can just focus on gathering food, and if he wishes, maybe getting a little bit of early wood to get his manor houses down a little bit quicker than regular houses, because they will give him additional settlers. So Minimalt can probably look at getting a lot of early banks out. He's going for three settlers to begin with. He does have a bank wagon there. He looks to be a pretty aggressive or tank oriented deck rather than one that'll really rely on a bank boom though. Nice little bit of wood there for Minimalt as well. So Musketeer. He's also shipped three vills. Possibly gonna go for Virginia Company. Make his mana's quite a bit cheaper.
Ready.
The only problem is it makes them that spare me that their build XP becomes so inconsequential while their kill XP is still quite reasonably high. Much higher than a regular house. That 81 to 40 for a regular house. But sniping the houses once you start pushing into the British player actually starts to really give you a nice XP gain. As much as the houses are quite tanky. So Minimalt only just now starting to gather some gold once again. Musketeer.
Ready.
Picking a nice treasure up there. Minimalt just looking at shifting the ibexes back a little bit here.
Commandment.
The villager going to be able to kill the war dog pretty quickly actually. So Minimalt just going to focus on bringing the Ibex is closer back to his base, just herding them closer to home. Looks like Musketeer is pinching a little bit of wood here.
Commandment.
going for a forward barracks. And the beauty of bringing only one settler and building the manor house is that he'll get the other settler there. He can leave, you know, the rest of his villas back at home. Yes. Even going to bring an outpost wagon forward now. He's got the coin he needs to make musks, should he need to. Well, we're going to see early Crabat from Minimalt here. There's already a Halbout as well. Try and harass. So Minimalt's actually going to pick off both of these vills by the look of it. Really nice for him.
Commando?
Musketeer's going to get five muskets out. But it'll be just too late to save James Chancellor. Already some Crabat just to make sure the kill is secured, but now the musts are here. They are going to be able to pick off possibly the Explorer. Definitely going to get that Halb. But the Crabat going to take a nice fight while the musts are in melee mode against the Explorer. This has been rough here for Musketeer. It's been a great fight for Minimalt so far. So Musketeer now only going to have the one musket left, waiting for his Explorer to get enough health to actually come back to life. It's going to be rough for him defending this against Minimalt. He's going to have another Crabat behind this. These are quite an expensive unit. They do actually get veterancy boosts here, so these guys have a little bit of extra damage and health now that they've picked off a couple of kills. Barracks going to be under a bit of threat. Awesome Crabat out. More of Minimalt's Crabat now coming out to support this, but there's only another two musts to back this up as well. Defensive. A more defensively placed barracks this time in range of the outpost. So Minimalt punishing the aggression so far from Musketeer with his Cafe Clongers. Let's go back. Gonna be microed really well against the Musketeers now. They're wanting to try and engage them at melee range, but Minimalt is having none of this. It's a great micro here from him. Just kept them all alive, but Musketeer might be able to pick off that one. It's quite low now. But he's just looking to flee. He's lost basically everything out of this force. And again, he's just back to producing muskets. Still not have the most enjoyable of trades against cavalry. Some of these Crabats talking out there with a little bit of extra health. So they basically gain an extra 99 health. Doesn't look like they really gain much else on top of that. Was it attack speed, not attack damage that they actually gain? So the promotions must actually give them, I think, attack speed rather than attack damage, as well as, yeah, giving them up to a potential 99 more health. So they can take a couple extra shots there. Like, he'd be dead without the veterancy. That's how powerful it is. So it's been really, really wonderful for Minimalt. I don't think he's lost anything so far, other than the one halberdier. He's taken out a barracks so far. Switching to skirmishes and having taken fast fortress age behind this, pretty well a semi-fast fortress, be pretty scary for musket right now. He's gonna have to try and a job and also deal with this big flurry of cavalry. And pretty much any civ these days can just get, you know, the church building, get the healer unit, and start healing all these guys up too if he wants. They're hunting dogs now for musketeer, but it's laid in to start getting all these eco-techs. But he does actually have the gold mining eco-tech placer mines over Minimolth at the moment. Gathering a lot of wood at the moment. So musketeer going to try and wall himself in on this front, just to try and protect this hunt. It's probably one of his most risky to hold on to against his opponent at the moment. Minimolt, things are going well. Even got the four banks. Producing quite a bit of coin for him. This will be a nice catch. The Minimolt, I think. Actually pulling the cravat back because he doesn't want to lose them. Now that there's quite a good musk number. So he's going to use the skirms actually for the most part. And now musketeer needs to really have some longbowmen or some hussar of his own to try and take a nice fight into this composition. So Minimolt compositionally just seems to really have everything going the way he's wanted all game. Off another settler now, so musketeers on 34 vils to the 25 of Minimolt, but bearing in mind there's 11 houses here for musketeer. Here we go, he's losing even more vils now. He's forced to gather under town center with units garrisoned there. Some canary guard now for Minimolt. Alongside his skirms. I think these guys, they have slightly more range. Yeah, they do have slightly more range than the Krabat. So not going to be as easy to pick off by the masks. Well, it still also prevents a really easy transition into the Hussar, because between the Krabat and the Canary Guard, they should be able to pick them off pretty quickly. They're both anti-cav cavalry, so to speak. And so musketeer's not quite able to get the envoy, and he's going to lose a couple of musks for his troubles. Really rough for him. He's got to get those settlers out of there too. Another one of those falling. The Hussar's trying to pick a nice battle, but fortunately it is a little bit of a bait for them. They are going to fall quite quickly here. And now musketeer versus skirmisher and mixed range cav. It's not the best of fights for musketeer, but I think he's taking a bit of a last stand, and GG. Well played. Minimolt takes it 2-0.